So this is what I asked. For example, so you need to use at least two adapters or three adapters, right? That's what the ask. And you need to use some specific set of parent functions. So you need to use any of the at least three adapters from this listing, and you have to use these parent functions. If you scroll down a bit, okay. So these are the parent functions that you have to use, and if you scroll down further, and you have to use a Groovy scripting step, and some message logging should happen there as well, and you can also use simple structures, either JSON or XML. So this is good. Okay, very good.
Coming to the use case of this scenario, a daily job like CPI is used to pick the data from JSON. If we use to pick the data as a JSON file with the product details via HTTPS. So each recorded include like product ID, name, category, and the price. Records are in this step. Records are enriched with the timestamp using Groovy, and data is inserted into database by using JDBC adapter. So errors are handled through exception subprocess, and notification is sent via AMQP if any error occurs. So this is a sample payload which I have used. So first I'll explain the flow.
Data structure, yes.
So yeah, sender adapter, we have chosen like HTTPS. Then here we have like Groovy script to enrich the data, and then followed by the message mapping, and then it is used to insert the data into the SQL like database. So here is the external system, like sender adapter. Here the system is like external HR system will be sending the payloads, and the internal employee database is, we can assume like it is an external HR system is used to send the payload, and internal employee database is our JDBC server, like JDBC receiver. And for here we can accept like if any error occurred, it will send a notification through to our AMQP server. Here AMQP I have used our academy test servers. So here JDBC, we have used like CrateDB. It's an open source database, like external system database. So
this is a target system, okay?
This is the target system, sorry. So yeah, if I deploy the iFlow. This is our product ID. Let me change. Previously, I have used this credential. Let me change some data.
So you have the product information ID, name, category, price, and some import timestamp and some information. Okay. So import timestamp is missing here. Okay.
Yeah. So timestamp is missing here. It will fetch from the Groovy script, which we have used in the next step here.
Okay.
Yeah. So it is just a sample payload. Just for testing purpose. Check the entity is like 200. Okay, it is successfully inserted into the receiver system.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is one which have just now I have submitted these two records. It is successfully came to our database. Yeah. So timestamp will be, this is a timestamp which is enriched from the Groovy script.
Okay, very good. Yeah. Can you open the iFlow please again?
Sorry. Yeah.
And can you just show me the adapter configuration on sender side and receiver side, both?
Yeah. Adapter configuration would be like sender side. This is a sender side configuration. So address is like product master data. And the rest of them I have keep it as default. So, and coming to the receiver type, there are like two receivers. It's for exception subprocess, and one is for internal employee database. So, firstly, we need to create a JDBC material. We need to store these details, like create our database details in the JDBC, so that it will connect to the external database. So the main purpose of the JDBC. Yeah. if we go to the monitor section, integrations and APIs, in this section, if we scroll down, we'll like in the message security, there is a section called JDBC material. Yeah, here we need to create a data source. Here we need to give like user and JDBC URL, all those things we need to mention that. And coming to this sender side connection. So like JDBC source alias would be createDB, which we have created in the JDBC material, and connection timeout like things maximum records is, here I kept like maximum resorts. These are acceptable as per our side. So coming to the exceptions of error logging. So
can you show me the Groovy script 1 and 2, please? What have you done there? Can you just show me this code?
So here in this Groovy script. So like it is importing all the necessary. This is the Groovy script 1. This is importing all the necessary packages, and here in the second step, it is defining the process data and like parsing the XML in the eighth step, and like current current data stream to fetch the current data stamp. It is used to it will get the current timestamp here, and this is used to convert and followed by.
Why did you use XMLSlurper?
Sorry,
the line number eight. Why did you use the XML slurper class?
Prasad, Groovy script I just used it from the AI chat box.
Basically for XML management, XML reading and writing, you need to use XML slurper class. Okay, so this is what the line number eight XML SLURPE slurper. So this is a class we use for XML processing. And you're trying to do, my understanding is you're reading the XML and you're just updating the code of this timestamp with the new timestamp. Okay.
So I have practiced all classes, but I just need to be perfect in this Groovy. And this current project, I just used AI tools for generating this project. I can understand this, what is happening in
this. That's fine. Yeah. That's fine.
Okay. I need to. Go ahead. Yeah, so coming to the second Groovy script.
So what is this doing?
Yeah, it is inserting the data. The external, our target database.
Okay, yeah. Got it. And you're also doing null validation, everything. Okay, that's good.
Yes. Yeah. So coming to exceptions of process, if we enter anything, here I have used a content modifier. So this is the error notification, timestamp, and so if any error in the payload, it will throw to our AMQP server.
Okay.
This is a receiver side configurations. Here I have used our test server. This is a host of the test server. Coming to processing, destination type would be a queue. Output destination name is the output. Yeah, that's all. That's all about this iFlow.
Can you simulate the error exception? Can you simulate the error scenario as well? How do you invoke the exception subprocess?
For example, here shall I remove any one of this?
If you try
with remove all the data,
I'll just remove this. This is empty payload I'm sending. Here it says 200. Okay, so coming to server. Yeah, here output is 2. You can see.
Okay, can you show me the message, please? There is a message in the.
Yeah. The... this is the error message.
Okay, I see. Okay, well done, Srini. And if you go back to the iFlow, please. Okay, I think you really designed well this integration flow, Srini. So you used all the three adapters which we asked for, and there is an exception subprocess handling the errors. I think you did a good job. Yeah, well done. And any feedback, Manoj and Munna?
I will be adding one thing. When you design the iFlow, right, mostly if you document in the Word document and represent it first, the data flow, it would be better. And later on, the technical details or technicality or functionality, you can explain on code. So better, it would be help you guys, like you are preparing a technical document as well. So before diving into the CPI tenant, just display or portray your technical document first in the Word, and later on you just move on to this.
Yes, Manoj, actually, thanks for the suggestion. Previously, we have submitted like this document, but like showing this, it will be handful, like it will be easy for me, so that I choose an iFlow. That's all. I have submitted this. We have created everything as like we took the screenshots and all those, explained everything and submitted. Like, hope you are like, this is fine, or do you want me to say anything? Like, anything specific?
This is fine. This is fine. But if you portray before on call directly rather than the technical, then it portrays that, yeah, technical document we have. It's the best practice that you have. You have a technical document, and later on you will be giving an KT like on exploring with the CPI tenant. So,
okay, Munna, thanks for the suggestion. Yeah, thank
well
you.
Well done, Sriniketa. Well done, good job, and yeah, good output. Thank you very much for showing this. Okay, well done.
Thank you.